Steven Spielberg is probably one of my favorite directors of all time. His mastery of cinema from the late 70s to the present has made him a household name so well known that he belongs in the Mount Rushmore of cinema, right up there with Walt Disney and Alfred Hitchcock. The post is set during the early 70s when a dossier revealing that officials knew that the Vietnam War was unwinnable is leaked. The Washington Post has received this material and is now racing against time to publish it before the government cracks down on them and, or worse, arrests them. For a film that, for the most part, is about newspaper etiquette, it really is a fascinating piece. It rings true in today's political climate when freedom of the press is a hot-button issue, and everything down to John Williams' score is just beautiful. But as a Spielberg fan, I gotta criticize. I love his historical dramas, but that's not the Spielberg I love. The Spielberg I grew up with was the man behind Jaws and Indiana Jones, behind Goonies and Saving Private Ryan. The man who mastered the story of an ordinary person in extraordinary circumstances. That's not to say that this film is weak, it's just that it's not necessarily an extraordinary story. It's a very simple historical piece that is honestly made to coincide with the times that we're in right now. But let's talk about some of the really good things. The acting in this film is phenomenal. Tom Hanks is just a superb talent. It's so fun to see him play these asshole types of characters. The entire film is really done from his perspective, and you can just see how he's just trying to get through everybody's head that this has to get done. He acts like the sane man in a room full of idiots. And even Meryl Streep, who balances uncertainty with overwhelming leadership, is amazing. Overall, the film is a perfectly fine film. It's not the best Spielberg film, but it's great for what it is. The Post. I liked it. I think you will too.